हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम एंड डूइंग हार्ड वर्क टू अचीव द गोल्स. स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस टू स्टैंडर्ड. एज यू नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 10, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ इनकम एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट. इन दिस चैप्टर टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस एग्रीगेट डिमांड, एग्रीगेट सप्लाई एंड कंजम्पशन फंक्शन. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज सेविंग फंक्शन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ सेविंग. सपोज अ पर्सन ए बी सी हैविंग इनकम रुपीज 10,000 and consumption it is rupees 7,000. So how you will calculate savings? That is 10,000 income minus consumption 7,000, you will get 3,000 rupees unspent as a saving. So saving is the income not spent, or you can say that deferred consumption. Methods of saving include putting money aside in, for example, saving deposit, fixed deposit, recurring deposit, pension account and investment fund. So saving also involves reducing expenditure. So saving is a function of income, and you know the equation, saving it is equals to y minus consumption. Y it is income minus consumption. So S is for saving, Y is the income, C is the consumption. This is we will consider as the first equation. Saving function of income, symbolically we can write it like this. Saving it is a function of income. Put the values of C. As in consumption function we have discussed, the consumption equation C it is equals to C bar plus BY, where C is consumption, C bar is the autonomous consumption, B is the slope of consumption and Y is the income. So put the values of C in this equation, we will get S is equals to Y minus bracket start C bar plus BY. After opening the brackets, you will get the equation like this: Y minus C bar minus BY. So here combine the Y values, minus C bar plus Y minus BY, take it inside the bracket, take the Y as a common factor out. So minus C bar plus 1 minus B, bracket close, into Y, where 1 minus B is the slope of the saving. Next one is S it is equals to autonomous consumption, it is this savings. So autonomous consumption can be equals to minus S bar, as autonomous consumption already having minus sign. So minus and this minus, it will be plus. So S bar plus MPS into Y. As you know that income having two aspects, having two concepts, that is consumption and saving. Either a part of income it is consumed, or entire income will be consumed, or a part of it is will be saved. So summation of MPC plus MPS it is equals to 1. As you know that MPC it is equals to B, that is the slope of consumption. Slope of consumption means change in consumption due to change in income. And MPS it is equals to 1 minus B, that is change in savings up due to change in income. Or you can say that ratio of change in saving due to change in income. So 1 minus B is the slope of saving. MPC plus MPS it is equals to 1. Put the values of MPC and MPS, you will get 1. We know that major part of income it is consumed and rest it is saved. So we can write the equation of income, that is income it is a summation of two components, that is consumption and saving. And change in income, it is the summation of change in consumption plus change in savings. We will consider this equation as number 1. Divide this equation by delta y both sides. Delta y means change in income. Delta y upon delta y, it is equals to delta c upon delta y plus delta s upon delta y, where delta c upon delta y, it is equals to MPC, that is marginal propensity to consume. Marginal propensity to consume is the ratio of change in consumption due to per unit change in income. And delta s upon delta y, it is equals to MPS, that is the ratio of change in saving due to per unit increase in income or change in income. So put these values here, you will get the equation like this. 1, it is equals to MPC plus MPS. In order to calculate MPC, we will shift MPS towards the left side and you will get the equation like this. MPC, it is equals to 1 minus MPS. In the same way, if we want to calculate MPS, we will shift MPC towards the left side and we will get the equation like this. MPS, it is equals to 1 minus MPC. Now, propensity to save. Propensity to save means different levels of savings at different levels of income. So, aspects of propensity to save, there are two aspects. First one is average propensity to save and second one is marginal propensity to save, as we have already discussed also. Let's take an example. Suppose national income, it is previously 10,000 and consumption was 7,000 and saving, it is equals to 10,000 minus 7,000, it was rupees 3,000. So saving, it is equals to rupees 3,000 and income, it is 10,000. So APS, it is equals to S upon Y, that is a ratio of saving upon income or aggregate saving upon national income. So put the values of aggregate saving, that is 3,000 divided by 10,000, you will get 0.3. So this 0.3 means that 30% of the national income, it is saved by the economy. Next one is marginal propensity to save. Marginal propensity to save, you know that it is a ratio of change in savings due to per unit change in income. Previously our income was 10,000, now increase in national income, it is 12,000. So change in income delta y, it is equals to 12,000 minus 10,000, it is equals to 2,000. Previously consumption was 7,000, now current consumption due to increase in income, it is 8,000. Now we can calculate delta C also in this way. Delta C, it is 8,000 minus 7,000 will give you 1,000. Due to increase in income, savings also increase to 4,000. Like 12,000 minus 8,000 will give you 4,000. Now change in savings, that is current savings 4,000 minus previous savings 3,000 will give you 1,000. Now we are having the values of delta S and delta Y. Put these values in the formula of MPS, that is 1,000 change in savings divided by 2,000, that is change in income, will give you 0.5. So 0.5 means that 50% of the additional income, it is saved by the economy. Next one is features of APS. APS means features of average propensity to save. First feature is average propensity to save, it is equals to 0 at the break-even point where consumption and income both are remains the same. Economy, it is in the equilibrium position. Average propensity to save cannot be equals to 1. The reason is this one, that savings cannot be equals to income. We always consume something. Third feature is average propensity to save cannot be greater than 1. The reason is this one, that savings cannot be more than income. Next one is fourth point, average propensity to save can be negative. Average propensity to save can be negative because when consumption, it is more than income. Number fifth point is average propensity to save increases with increase in income. Because when there is increase in income, people tends to save more. Now next one is, let's discuss the relationship between saving and income with the help of this table. In this table, first one we are having income that varies from 0 to 700 and consumption also increases with the increase in income. At zero level of income, consumption was 150, and this is autonomous consumption because it is independent of the level of income. We are having zero income but still we are having consumption, that is 150, minimum amount of consumption for survival. So this 150 we have spent from the past savings, that's why minus 150 showing the dis savings. As income increases, consumption also increases, but increase in income, it is more than increase in consumption. Income and consumption, they do not increase in the same ratio. Now at 300 level of income, consumption also 300, and at this point economy, it is in equilibrium, so savings are zero. After the equilibrium point, economy starts save. You can see at 400 level of income, consumption it is lesser than income and 50 rupees are saved in the economy. Now next one is, let's discuss all these points on the axis. On the x axis I have measured income, and on the y axis we will measure savings. Now see, first of all we will draw the saving curve in order to learn that how to calculate the slope of saving. At zero level of income, savings are 150. At 100 level of income, savings are minus 100. At 200 level of income, savings are 50. At 300 level of income, savings are 0. At 400 level of income, savings are 50. At 500 level of income, savings are 100. At 600 level of income, savings are 150. At 700 levels of income, savings are 200. Now after joining these points, I have got the saving curve starting from negative segment of the y-intercept, and it intersects the x-axis at point N, that is 300 level of income, saving it becomes 0, and after that it is positive. The value of savings are positive because in this segment consumption it is more than income. At N level of income, O N level of income, there is break even point due to income it is equals to consumption. Next one is, at the income level of 500, that is OM level of income, the consumption was MA. As the income level increases from OM to OH level, consumption also increases from HC to CB. HB. Previously it was HC, and with the increase in income, consumption also increases to HB. So this CB, it is the change in savings due to change in income. AC and MH both are same. Now मार्जिनल प्रोपेंसिटी टू सेव इट इज डेल्टा एस अपॉन डेल्टा वाई. हियर डेल्टा एस इट इज सी बी एंड डेल्टा वाई इट इज ए सी एंड दिस इज इक्वल्स टू 1 माइनस बी. बी इज द कंजम्पशन फंक्शन. एज यू नो दैट वी कैन ड्राइव द सेविंग्स फ्रॉम इनकम एंड कंजम्पशन. डन. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज दिस पार्ट दैट इज बिलो द ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट ऑन द सेविंग कर्व शोज दैट दिस इज दिस सेविंग्स ड्यू टू ऑटोनमस कंजम्पशन दैट इज द मिनिमम अमाउंट ऑफ कंजम्पशन दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू सर्वाइव. सो दिस इज नोन एज डिस सेविंग डिनोटेड बाय एस बार. नेक्स्ट वन इज ओ एन लेवल ऑफ इनकम इज सफिशियंट टू मीट द कंजम्पशन नीड्स इन द इकोनॉमी. सो एस एन लेवल ऑफ सेविंग शोज डिस सेविंग्स. This S N level shows dis savings because here income it is less than savings, or you can say that consumption it is more than savings. At this point income level to zero. After O N level of income, as income increases savings also increases. So S N part of dis saving needed to finance autonomous consumption. SN. This shows that we are financing autonomous consumption. Next one is relationship between average propensity to consume and average propensity to save. From here, this is the income level varies from 0 to 700. Consumption also increases with the increase in income. 150 autonomous consumption level. Because this consumption expenditure it is from our past savings, that's why this saving minus 150. From here we can calculate the savings y minus c will give you the savings. Economy it is in equilibrium at 300 level of income because income and consumption figures both are same, so savings are zero. After the equilibrium point in the economy there are savings. And before the equilibrium point in the economy, there are dis savings. Average propensity to consume, as you know that it is the ratio of saving over income. So, put the values of savings here. Savings it is minus 100 divided by 100 will give you minus 1. Minus 50 divided by 200 will give you minus 0.25. 0 divided by 300 will give you 0. 50 divided by 400 will give you 0.12. In the same way, you can calculate the average propensity to consume, average propensity to save for other values of savings and income. In the same way, we can calculate MPS, that is marginal propensity to save. That is the ratio of change in aggregate savings due to change in aggregate income, or you can say that national income. Now national income, first of all we have to calculate delta S. Delta S 100 minus 150 will give you 50. Like minus 100 minus 150 and minus minus plus, so minus 100 plus 150 will give you 50 upon 100. It will give you 0.5. In the same way, minus 50 minus bracket mein minus 100. So minus minus plus, so minus 50 plus 100 will give you 50. 50 upon 100 it is equals to 0.5. In the same way you can calculate the marginal propensity to save for other values of savings and income. Now next one is plot these values on the axis. On the x-axis we are measuring income. And on the y-axis, we are measuring saving and consumption. First of all, we will draw the consumption curve. Zero level of income. Consumption it is 150. Next one is 100 level of income. Consumption it is 200. 200 level of income. Consumption it is 250. 300 level of income. Consumption it is 300, 400 level of income consumption it is 350, 500 level of income consumption it is 400, and in the same way we can draw other points, and after joining the points we will get a upward sloping consumption curve starting from the y intercept, that is C, it is equals to C bar plus BY. Now next one is we will draw the saving curve. See, at zero level of income saving it is minus 150, at 100 level of income saving it is minus 100, at 200 level of income saving it is minus 50, at 300 level of income saving it is 0, at 400 level of income saving it is 50. After joining these points I have got this curve of saving starting from negative segment of the y intercept, and it intersects the x axis at 300 level of income, that is a break even point in the economy or the equilibrium level of the economy, and after that it's showing the savings in the economy. Before the break even point there are these savings. Next one is we will draw the income curve. Income curve also 100 level of income consumption it is 100, 200 level of income consumption and saving it is 200. In the same way we will mark the points, and after joining the points we will get this curve, that is y is equals to C plus S. In this segment you can see that consumption curve it is upper or above the income curve, so here consumption it is more than income, showing this savings in the economy. In this segment you can see income curve it is above the consumption curve, so showing savings in the economy. When the economy was equilibrium, that is at point B, income and consumption curve intersect with each other, at that time savings are zero, that is at 300 level of income. So this part of the savings showing that this is autonomous consumption expenditure, or you can say this savings, and this part showing the savings in the economy. As you know that average propensity to consume and average propensity to save it is equals to 1. The reason is this one, that national income is either consumed or saved because it is a summation of two components, that is consumption and saving. So divide both sides by income to this equation, that is y divided by y is equals to C divided by y, that is consumption divided by income plus savings divided by income. Now when YY cancel we will get 1, and as you know that CY it is nothing but it is the formula to calculate average propensity to consume, plus S upon Y it is also the formula to calculate average propensity to save. So put the values of C upon Y, that is APC, and S upon Y, that is of APS. So you will get that summation of average propensity to consume and average propensity to save, it will be equals to 1. In order to calculate average propensity to consume, we have to shift average propensity to save towards the left side, and we will get this equation, average propensity to consume, it is equals to 1 minus average propensity to save. In the same way, we can calculate APS by shifting APC towards the left side. So you will get the new equation, average propensity to save, it is equals to 1 minus average propensity to consume. Value of average propensity to save can be negative, as consumption it is more than income. With the increase in income, average propensity to consume decrease and average propensity to save increase continuously. The reason is this one, you know that with the increase in income people tends to save more. Now next one is, hope you all have understand the topic. Now students, it's the time टू नोट द नोट डाउन द होमवर्क एक्सप्लेन सेविंग फंक्शन विथ स्केड्यूल डायग्राम लेबल द डायग्राम प्रॉपरली एंड प्लीज गो थ्रू द यूट्यूब लिंक्स फॉर मोर क्लियरिटी थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग स्टूडेंट्स